In this video, I will show some functions from MicroBit version 2. It has a built-in microphone that can respond to sound. Here I make a servo motor turn when the MicroBit receives a sound. I have cut up a box and glued a scale on. At the bottom, I have made a hole for the servo motor shaft. I have glued the servo motor as shown here. As a pointer, I glued the end of a strip to one of the plastic pieces from the servo motor. The diagram for the setup looks like this. For a stable function, I have connected the servo motor to an external power source. Remember common ground. The connector at MicroBit version 2 has got a notched edge, which makes it easier to connect the test cords. In Make code for version 2, some sections have been added. Unfortunately, when sending larger and larger angles to the servo motor, it turns counterclockwise. Therefore, the program here counts the angle downwards so that the pointer moves clockwise. Instead of removing batteries, you can hold down the reset button for a while and the MicroBit will enter sleep mode. Version 2 can deliver a greater current than version 1. Here I test if it can run the servo motor with brand new batteries. It does not work very well, so you still need an external power supply. The next program looks like this. Here the sound level function is used. If the value is above 50, the servo motor responds with an appropriate stroke. To make the pointer turn clockwise, the values are reversed.